Hello friends, myself Amar. Now in this video I will discuss another prime facies chart which is called as the bubble chart. Okay, let me show you the first output. First, here you can see I have created two bubble charts. One is the normal bubble chart, and here I have created a bubble chart with custom options. Custom options means, if you can see here, there is a shadow. Okay, for the bubble there is a shadow, but for this bubble with custom options there is no shadow. Here you can see this bubble has a constant background color, but this bubble has a gradient background color. If you can see in the normal bubble chart, these labels you can see here, but in the bubble charts with custom options you can see these labels are being tilted. Okay, how to create this bubble chart using prime facies, that portion I will discuss today. Okay, to create the bubble chart, what you need to do, you need to use the P column chart as we did for area chart and bar chart. But here, to create the bubble chart, the type will be bubble. Okay, and in the model, what I am using bubble chart dot bubble model 1. And to create the bubble chart with custom options, which property I am using, bubble model 2. Okay, and this bubble chart is nothing but the name of the managed bin. Right, now if I go to the managed bin, then here you can see that I have created a class bubble model, and the name of the managed bin I have given as bubble chart. Right, now here I have created the object of class bubble chart model, and the name I have given as bubble model 1 and bubble model 2. Remember one thing, this bubble model 2 will be used for the bubble chart with custom options. Okay, now in the init method, what I am doing, I am calling a method create bubbles model. And after that, what I have done, I have created the getter and setter for these properties. As you can see, get and set. Okay, now in the create bubble models method, what I am using, I am using bubble model 1 equals to init bubble model. Okay, now in the init bubble model method, what I have done, I am using the bubble chart model class, means I have created the object of the bubble chart model class, and with this bubble chart model class I am adding the bubble chart series, the object of the bubble chart series class. And this bubble chart series class takes four parameters. Okay, this one, this first two is the string parameters, and this is nothing but the radius, the last one is the radius. Okay, and this is 183. As you can see here, this 183 is nothing but the value, right? And this 55 is nothing but the last parameter, is nothing but the radius of the bubble, right? Here I have added Java book, Python book, Ruby, Scala, ASP.NET, C and C++. That's why so many bubbles you are seeing here, right? Now, what I have done here, this init bubble model method, what it will do, it will add all the bubble chart series with the bubble chart model, right? Now after that, I have set the title as bubble chart. For the x axis, the label as price. For the y axis, the label as labels, having the minimum value as 0 and maximum value as 250. That's why the minimum value of y axis is 0, maximum value is 250, and this is the labels, right? And similarly for bubble model 2, this means with custom options, again I am calling the init bubble model. And the title I have given is bubble chart with custom options, as you can see here, bubble chart with custom options. After that, set shadow, I have made it as false, by default it is true. Set bubble gradients, by default it is false, I have made it as true. That's why for the custom options you can see a background gradient color, right? After that, for the x axis, the tick angle is, I have set as minus 50. That's why you are seeing a tilt value. For the y axis also, I have made the tick angle as 50. That's why for the y axis also there is a tilted value for the labels, right? This is how we can create a bubble chart model in prime facies. Let me show you the code once again. This is the managed bin. The name of the class is bubble model, and the name of the managed bin I have put as bubble chart. I have created the object of two class bubble chart model. and I have created two properties, bubble model 1, bubble model 2. This bubble model 2 will be used for the bubble chart with custom options. Okay, after that I have created the getter and setter method for these properties. In the init method I have called the create bubble models method, and inside the create bubbles model method I am creating the object of the bubble model 1. Okay, and I have put the title, I have put the value of x axis and y axis. Okay, similarly for the bubble model 2 also I am calling the init bubble model method. I have set the title and I have used some custom options. Okay, and set the value of x axis and y axis. And in the init bubble model method, what I have done, I have used the bubble chart series class, and the value of the bubble chart series class is being added with this model, right? Now remember this, that the last one is nothing but the radius of the bubble. Okay, now let me show you, let me increase the radius, let me do it as 80. Save this. I have increased the radius for the Java book. Okay, now if I run this once again, then you can see for the Java book the radius will be increased. See, the radius has been increased. Okay, this is how we can use bubble chart in prime faces. Okay, I hope you have liked my video. If you liked my video, please subscribe my channel, share, comment. Thank you so much.